Hi, Rain here. I'm the editor of CGRocks and I'd like to just do a quick video on tuning. I have two tuning devices here. I've got an old fashioned tuning fork, which is A440, and then I have these wonderful little snark tuners. These are great, they do tune nicely, but more importantly, they clip on and they're silent. So, what's the difference? The snark tuner is great because it'll give you the exact pitch of each string. So if I just do that there, you should be able to see it. There's going to be tiny discrepancies there because I have not tuned my guitar with the snark tuner. Why? Well, the guitar is a funny instrument, and on most guitar bodies, the G string does not fall into line easily. You either got to put it up a little or you're going to drop it down a little. For some reason, it's just the way it is. Sometimes, because of that, the bridges on the back of the guitar are different. On my Michael G, I don't have a standard bridge. Michael has put in individual bridges for each string and set them so that they help tune. So I'm actually lucky this guitar stays in tune wonderfully. Can't highly recommend Michael G. So on other guitars, you'll have a straight bridge or sometimes you'll have lifts or dents. But even with this guitar to a certain degree, I have got to work the tuning. So I'll find A on my snark tuner. Once that's in, I will then tune A to A. And then B to B. I will then tune fourths. I will then tune into the E octaves and I'll check the B against the E as well, and it should, and then I'll tune octaves again. And as I'm tuning this, you'll see that there's discrepancies with the snark tuner with that, but for me it's a personal thing. Tuning, I like certain intervals to be in a certain way. A great video to check out is Martin Taylor's discussion on tuning and what he does. But with the snark tuner, I don't use the snark tuner as much as I use this. This little puppy is wonderful, mainly because I can then put, instead of the snark tuner being here, I can put the A in my head. Watch. Not recommended if you've got false teeth. Tune into A because they all have A in their upper harmonic range. The only one that won't tune in is the B string because it doesn't. So once you've got all those others in tune with the A, open string, or octaves, or even if you're brave enough, thirds. And as you can hear, the thirds are not quite in there. And there you go, the thirds are in. Key tip to tuning. Go down below the note, tune up to the note, don't tune down. And that's literally got to do with the nut, because if you tune down, it sometimes gets stuck, especially if you haven't lubricated it using graphite or a pencil, you know, just a standard pencil, rub it in. It'll get it just tiny bit stuck, and as you play, you push in, it'll pull that out and pull it out of tune. So always tune up to a note. Hopefully this little tip helps. Thank you. If you like what you hear, follow the link coming up now, or follow the links below to Classical Guitar Rocks, where we've got loads more lessons for classical guitar.